I'm Jessica Beckham, and I'm a PhD candidate in environmental science here at the University of North Texas, and I'm studying bumblebees, and I'm looking at how they're using the urban spaces here in Denton County, and I'm also looking at the persistence of historical species across our region. And in that study, I've been looking at the presence of these species in 16 of our counties. So I've driven 3,000 miles over the last two summers and found two different species. Here in Denton County specifically, we've got a good population of bumblebees. We've got two species that are here in pretty good numbers, and I'm finding them in our urban spaces. So what I'm taking from that is that places like community gardens and our urban wild spaces are important to support our native bumblebee populations. So for homeowners who are looking to also help with that effort, even a very small flower garden can help because bumblebees will be able to find that and forage on it. So what we've got here are the historical records of bumblebees here in the Elm Fork Natural Heritage Museum. And these kind of provide a regional record of the bumblebee species that have been here. Our most common species in the area, this is Bombus pennsylvanicus, also known as the American bumblebee. These are Bombus fraternus, which is our second most common individual. Interestingly, when I first started this study and started going through these records, I found that Bombus fraternus fell out of these records in 1998. So I was concerned that maybe that species was gone from our area, but when I actually went out in the field back in 2013, we did find Bombus fraternus, and subsequently I've found Bombus fraternus in a lot of the counties in our region. Bumblebees are important pollinators of many of our plants and also our food products that we eat. They pollinate some of the foods that honeybees can't pollinate, and some examples of those are chili peppers and tomatoes. Generally speaking, they're also really good for our ecosystems, because without pollination in our ecosystems, you don't have the flowers blooming, you don't have them reproducing, and that affects the entire ecosystem as a whole.